gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Baby Show stage with Made for Mums. We've had a great day so far up here. We've had some amazing experts. It's been really busy. How is it out there? It looks busy out there. Lots of shopping to be done. Guys, have they spent all your pennies? I bet they have. Oh, it'll be worth it. It is the ultimate show for any new parents, grandparents, all the shopping. It's a lovely day out. I'm going to bring out a lady who is an experienced baby-wearing consultant. She runs the South London Sling Library, which is the largest and busiest sling library in the UK. A lovely warm welcome, please, for Emily Williamson. Hello, Emily.
Hello.
I've just been raving about slings. My memory of the sling and how it got me through those early days. Absolutely did, without a doubt. If there's one piece of equipment, it would be that. So tell us a bit more about yourself and how you're here today.
So I run a sling library, which is a service that helps parents find out about all the different slings and carriers so they can work out what's right for them.
Brilliant. I mean, the sling library, this is something new. Is this from you being a mum yourself?
Absolutely.
And thinking, I don't know which sling to go for?
Exactly. Very similar experience to yourself, actually. My eldest, I would never have imagined I needed to carry him for as long as I did, but I found myself spending 3-4 years humping him about on one hip, and it really hurt my back. So when I was pregnant the second time, I tried to find out a bit more about different ways of doing it more comfortably, and I found it really hard. And then I realized that everyone else was having the same experience, so I set up the service to help other people find out.
Brilliant idea. And so now you're going to take us through various slings they can find here at the show.
Yeah, absolutely. So I'm going to go through a few of the benefits of using a comfortable wrap, sling or carrier. Benefits for your baby as well as for yourself.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's some really amazing things which I'll be talking about.
Lovely.
And then we'll look at some of the slings and carriers that are available here. You'll have a chance to see them and we'll tell you a bit more.
Lovely, Emily. Well, I'm going to hand over to you and I'll join you at the end. Good
Lovely.
Luck. Enjoy.
Thank
see you.
See
you in a moment.
Hello. So whether you've been thinking about buying a carrier or not yet, when your baby's born, you'll be needing to lift and carry and hold them. Newborn babies need us to do an awful lot for them. We need to clean them and feed them, and we need to carry them about from place to place. Lots of parents also find that using a sling or carrier or just holding your baby in your arms is the easiest and most reliable way to calm them and to stop them crying. And there's actually some really important reasons why this really does work. So I don't know how many of you are pregnant here today. I've seen a lot of pregnant mums around. Imagine what it's like for your newborn whilst they're in your tummy. It's somewhere warm and close, and there's reassuring whooshing noises of your body and the movements as you walk around. That's all very calming for a baby. When they're first born, the world is very different. It's cold and bright, and lots of babies take a little time to adjust. Many parents find that the first few months is quite difficult as a baby settles in. Using a sling or carrier helps to replicate that lovely snug feeling, and being held safely against your chest really does calm a baby. And it's been shown that babies who are carried regularly cry less. And there's loads of benefits for a baby's development as well. Not only do they spend less time crying, but when they're held close to your body weight, babies can actually more easily regulate their temperature, their heart rate, their breathing. It helps them to relax tensed muscles, and all that energy that they're not wasting doing that, they can put into growing and learning instead. So it really helps support them. They've actually found that very small babies who are carried regularly tend to put on weight more quickly. And again, that just shows how they're not wasting energy doing other things. It's not just great for physical development. Using a sling or carrier helps to support your baby's social and language development as well. When they're in a sling, they're up at the same level you are, they're taking part in your day, they get to experience everything that you do. When they're relaxed and alert in a sling, they're constantly taking in from their surroundings, even from newborn. Now, newborns, they can't see as far as we can, but they have excellent hearing, so they really are absorbing all of that information around them. With all that growing and learning that they're doing, babies need regular naps. And in a supportive carrier, a baby can nap very comfortably. It's actually safer for a new baby, a small baby, to nap in an upright position like this in a sling or carrier than it is to lie in a room on their own. And that's because it's so easy for you to monitor their well-being. You can so easily see that they're doing well, check that everything's fine. So not only are slings great for keeping them relaxed and calm, they're also great for some other problems you might experience. I know that Lucy just mentioned about colic. Lots of parents, if you have a new baby, you may have experienced how awful it is when a baby is very uncomfortable in their digestion and they can't calm down, they can't relax. Being held close to your body on your stomach like this actually means that the movements of your body as you breathe are naturally massaging your baby's tummy. And the upright position and the movements as you walk around will naturally to help their digestion and help everything move up and down as it needs to. So it really does help to keep them calm. It also helps to keep them active. You might be surprised to hear this, but in an upright position, in a sling or a carrier, a baby's actually able to use all of their upper back and neck muscles and even start to develop their sense of balance against gravity because they're experiencing all these movements whilst in the sling. They're not just lying inactive, so it can help to develop muscle tone as well. And all these amazing benefits you can get simply by carrying your baby in a comfortable sling or carrier. You don't have to think about it. You don't have to buy anything else special to make sure that that part of their development is supported. It happens automatically for you whilst you've got both hands free and you're able to get on with your day. So it's really practical for you as well. As we heard already, using a sling can be a lifesaver. There's some lovely photos coming up to show just some of the examples of where it can be really useful to use a sling or carrier. If you have an older child, it can be brilliant to help you get out and about. And there's some loads of other benefits for parents too. So using a sling or carrier is fantastic for bonding with and getting to know your baby. Because they're held so close to you, you get to sense all of the little movements and faces they pull and get to learn what they mean. So if they have a certain face they pull just as they're getting hungry, you notice it, they start to cry, you know exactly what it is that you need to do to sort that out and get them calm again quickly. It's great for feeding, so I just mentioned feeding. Carrying a baby helps to support and maintain successful breastfeeding. And for mums, this is magical. For mums, if you hold a baby close here on your chest, it actually helps your body produce more milk. So it really does help. If you're a dad or if you're bottle feeding, then using a sling or carrier can help you get that sense of closeness and give you the extra hand or arm that you need to maybe get on with something else whilst you're doing it. So slings are fantastic for around the home. And here's a gorgeous photo of baby sleeping as well. They're also great for getting you out and getting you active. So when you're using a comfortable sling or carrier, it will support your posture, protect your back, allow you to get out of the house and get to places that buggies just can't go. So around London, public transport, it can be so awkward with a buggy, no problem with a sling. It also really does help to keep you fit. If you're using a comfortable carrier like I am, it will distribute the weight evenly. I'm not using my shoulders or back muscles to hold the weight like you would in your arms. I'm using my core, so it will help me develop my core strength. It's great following pregnancy, and it helps to keep me fit. So some fantastic benefits to everyone for using a comfortable carrier. More and more people are discovering these benefits, and you may have noticed there's lots of different types of slings here at the show. So lots of people want to find out what they should use, how can they get into carrying, and what would be right for them. So I'm now going to talk a little bit about some of the different slings and maybe what you might be looking for when you want to think about what might be right for you and your family. So I've got some lovely models here to help me. Thanks, guys. So there's quite a few different slings. Here's just an example of some of them. Lots of different slings, but they all have very important things in common. All of these carriers are designed to support you holding your baby in the same way that you naturally would in your arms. So Steve, for example, he's got the ring sling with a little newborn baby and a cradle hold. What it allows you to do is hold the weight close to your body, and then you can let go. So it's a hands-free way of holding your baby comfortably close to you, supporting your back. The other thing that's super important, and you can see with all of these, is safety for your baby. You want your baby to be supported from the top of its head to the bottom of its spine appropriately to its developmental level. So Steve has a newborn here, needs its head supported. Got a much older baby in these two slings. They're a bit more active. They could get their arms out if they wanted to. But they're still supported safely, securely against your body. Thanks, guys. Right. Now we're going to look at some of the specific types of carriers. So we've got some more models coming on to show you some particular brands. We're going to be showing the logos are coming up. So if you see something you like, do remember what it is. You can always ask about it at the end. So we're talking about wraparound and tie-on slings. These are stretchy wraps, stretchy slings like the one I'm wearing. They're fantastic to use from newborn. They distribute the weight evenly around your body without pressure points for you or your baby. So how's it feel, guys? And you can see here, again, the newborn's got its legs snugged up exactly how it likes to be, and a more active baby can get up and get active. The fantastic thing about these slings, lots of people think they look complicated to use, but actually, you only need to tie it on yourself once, and then you can leave it on yourself, pop your baby in and out as you need. You don't need to retie it each time. It makes it really, really convenient to use with a small baby at home whose needs are changing regularly. It will always adjust to fit you comfortably. Thanks so much. And you can see the weight distribution evenly spread out across the back. Again, it's not going to pull at your shoulders or at your back. So next, we've got some more wraparound slings. This is a woven wrap. It looks very similar to the ones we just saw, but actually this doesn't have any stretch. It makes it more supportive for a heavier baby and gives you more options for tying it. So you can make it suit a greater range of babies and adults as well. This woven wrap, you can see all you need to do to adjust it for your baby's comfort, for your comfort, is to spread out the straps. You can mess around with it, whatever feels good for you. Steve's wearing our Maytai. Exactly the same adjustability, weight distribution on the back, fantastic support for the baby. A little bit less fabric, so for people who don't like the complete lack of structure of the wrap, it gives you a bit more structure and support. Why don't you guys show everyone? So these can both be used on the back and the hip, as well as on the front. They give you lots of carrying options. And they're really great if you're trying to fit carriers to different sized adults and adjust them to fit different sized parents. Thanks so much, guys. Next, we're going to be looking at soft structured carriers. So more structured carriers are designed to support you and your baby. They have a particular kind of shape that will fit your baby, fit your body. We've got some different brands here. Different brands will offer different carrying positions. You can see we've got one on the back here. And that also goes on the front, and they'll fit different shapes and size babies as well. These can be really quick, really convenient to use, very supportive for long walks if they fit you. The important thing to be aware of with these more structured carriers, as you can see, is that different carriers will suit different people. The shapes will suit different body shapes better. So try them on before you buy and check how they feel. That's fantastic. Thank you. Last of all, we're going to look at one-shouldered slings. I hope we've got one coming out shortly. There's a couple of different types of these one-shouldered slings. They basically will give you a pocket to pop your baby into at the front or on the back. Thank you, here we are, fantastic. So again, it's supporting you carrying your baby in exactly the same way you naturally would on your hip, but you can let go. It's very convenient, packs away really small, fantastic for having in your bag just in case you need it. You can even carry a toddler in this kind of sling. So again, great for when they're walking along, their legs get tired, and you just want something to pop them into quickly. The rings allow you, I don't know if you can show this, allow you to adjust it perfectly to suit you, so you can just pull the fabric through the rings like this. to adjust to fit your baby as they grow and change shape. Because remember, your baby will be growing and changing shape, and you may want different things to suit different stages. Thank you. Okay, so there's a few of the different kinds of slings and carriers. One of the things I most commonly get asked is parents say, what would be best for me? What sling would be best for my baby, for me to do walking the dog or breastfeeding or whatever I need? Now, to be honest, that's a question that I get very evasive about. I can't answer that for you. Slings and carriers are very personal, and different slings will feel different to different people. It's just like anything else that needs to be fitted to your body shape in order to be supportive or comfortable. So think more like shoes or jeans or something else that you would always try on to check is right for you before you buy it. As I mentioned earlier, different brands may suit different people better. So it's always great to have a go with lots of different kinds before you really decide what to buy. think about when you're going to use a carrier, how long for at a time. And do remember that your baby may have quite strong preferences about all of this too. So try it on with your baby if possible. If your baby's not here yet, that's fine. You could use a doll. You could even borrow a baby. See how it feels for you. See how comfortable it is and how easy it is to use. The tie-on ones, as I said earlier, some people may not have experienced that. They may not be so sure. And they may think it's a bit difficult, but do try them on. Lots of people find them very intuitive. It's just like tying shoelaces. Equally, lots of people love the buckles and how quick and secure that feels. Give it a try, see how it feels to you. So I'm coming to the end of my talk today. Here there's lovely models coming back on to show. Another really important thing to remember is what you like the look of. So have a look at some of the lovely things we have that we've been modeling today. What do you think looks great? What would you feel really confident and comfortable carrying your baby in for as much of the time as you or your baby wants to?
I'm just coming on just to say, can we have another round of applause for our models, please, first?
Absolutely.
Have
another
walk
down, guys.
Thanks so much,
guys. It's been fantastic.
Thank you very much, guys. Adele, Jodie, Emma, Katie, and Steve. They'll be back later with the Mother Care Show with their babies again as well. So we'll see them again today. Thanks, guys. That was really great, Emily.
Thank
and
you.
A lovely little pose as well. They like to milk it, don't they?
Yeah.
Gorgeous. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now we'll have a chat. Emily, that was great. And it's a really nice thing to do because there is a lot of choice out there and it can be confusing. Good bit of advice there to try them on. Because these take a bit of practice. I think I tried quite a few times putting it on and off before the baby came with a teddy. My daughter thought I was mad.
That can be a really great way of practicing.
But when they're crying, when baby's crying, and you're trying to be calm and put it on, I needed a little plan. And I used to even know when they were going to get cranky and I needed that sling. And I used to have it laid out on my bed in a way that I knew to get it on. Little tricks of the trade like that. By the end, I was absolutely fine. But what you don't want to do is you're getting in a tiz, baby's getting a tiz, you give up and you throw it in the corner of the room and you don't use
absolutely.
It.
Absolutely. And
wonderful.
It's a really important point to make. Lots of babies will fuss when you first put them in a sling or carrier, but they fuss when you do anything with them, changing their nappies, putting them in a car seat. Once they're in, make sure they're calm and happy and go for a walk.
Once
you get moving,
that naturally
soothes them, and then you'll see how much they like it.
I agree. Hours and hours I have my little fella in one of those. So please do go. And can they find you here at the show, Emily? Is
yes,
there a certain
absolutely.
Place you can find you?
So I'm here all weekend offering advice and helping people try on a range of carriers at the Cheeky Rascals stand, which
Cheeky
is
Rascals.
Way over that way at stand E30,
H30. H30 Cheeky Rascals. Head over. You've got Emily here today, which is amazing. Go and have a chat. Maybe try some slings on. Definitely do it. It's so worth doing. And I'd just like a really lovely round of applause, please, for Emily.
Thank you
so
much.
From the Sling Library. Thank you so much, Emily. Well done. Good job there. Still lots more to come here on the Baby Show stage. Make sure you do join us.